Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Misty Continent Cursed Island on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5 that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Misty Continent Cursed Island and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Misty Continent Cursed Island. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all folks, to get started we need to open our main web browser. We selected the one we use by default. Let's go to the next URL that I have highlighted in green. Now, you are able to see on the screen of the PC. There is no need to type anything, because there's the clickable link in the video description and the first main comment. We landed here on our internet site of Usitility, where we include a detailed outline on the best way to obtain Misty Continent Cursed Island on computer. We scroll down a bit and mouse click on the Download Game on PC button. After clicking on the link, we get to the site of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we are going to use to play Misty Continent Cursed Island on the PC. As you can discover here we access a great deal of pros of using the emulator. Now we will proceed to download the Misty Continent Cursed Island by simply clicking on the button Play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green. We then click on the button. And the download starts and ends immediately. Voila, this is the download. It is a file to execute. What we are going to do is to launch the executable file, okay, so we have to click on the file. If we are on Windows 10 it will have asked us for permission to make changes to the system. We said yes. I minimize the browser to see the installation software much better. The installer is very simple to use. It consists of a couple of options, install, and setup path. I will explain what setup path does indeed. We simply just click it. And now we see that we have here the path where the emulator will be placed. If we want to modify this folder we have to click on the browse option, so we pick another directory and install the emulator specifically where we like. To keep it simple, just keep it by default. Then, I click on back. So I click on install. Voila! The installation starts and it is going to continue in the download of these megabytes that happens to be shown on that computer screen. At the time you download it, it may be more or less MB. The data transfer rate may go at a higher speed or slower, depending on your internet and according to the data transfer rate of the emulator hosting servers. Immediately they are progressing extremely fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this moment, the emulator has been launched on autopilot. As you can observe, down here, there is a progress bar which will advance to the right then when it reaches the finish, the emulator is started for the first time. The truth is the emulator has already been launched there for the first time. Before we carry on, as you can see, it has created a couple of icons there on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon is going to be the one we are concerned about. Anytime we desire to run Misty Continent Cursed Island on our laptop or computer, we twice click on this specific icon and launch the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Why don't we do the next step, which is actually a must, and this is to access the Google Play Store. And we will click on Play Store. As you can observe the Google Play is launched. Here we have got to sign in. At this point when we are right here, we are required to conduct the following step that is definitely compulsory. Therefore we mouse click on Sign In. At this moment it says Checking Info. It can occasionally get stuck in Checking Info, additionally it does not progress. If that's the case, you can try to connect to your account after a few hours and it will surely probably be resolved. At this moment we are going to enter our username and password. The email address must be a Gmail email address as well as its matching password. For example you make use of the very same email address you are using right now in your own YouTube account. Then I am going to type my data and I will come back immediately after I have accomplished it. That's it, data entered. Find out Google welcoming us and offering us their terms of service. We can say yes to all of them simply by clicking, I agree. Following, it offers us to backup to the Google Cloud. You might leave it selected and it will produce a backup of your data on that device to Google Drive. I am not going to check it, you do what you want. We click on accept. Google Play Store is launched by default and on autopilot. To install the video game, we need to visit the emulator desktop for Android by simply clicking this app icon designated green colored. Right now that we are on the desktop of the emulator for Android, we see that we have now here the install video game option. We simply click on the button. There we have the game. How about we click on now on the install button that I am presenting now in green color. And this will start the installation. Right now it will download and install the video game, it can take a little while or it may possibly be amazingly quickly. That all depends on our internet access. This has already completed installing. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by clicking on this option that I am emphasizing in green, in order to run Misty Continent Cursed Island for the very first time. We're already on the emulator desktop, and then we're going to simply click this brand new Misty Continent Cursed Island software icon which has been created. This game is launched for the first time on your computer. Currently there we end up with it, I can press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I should comment on the volume of that emulator. It is right here. We have the icon of higher volume and also the icon of lower volume. This manner we are not going to rely on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the music of this emulator. And to enjoy the experience to the fullest, we should turn on the large monitor, for which we have two choices. This is the first one, we simply click on this app icon that I'm designating in green color. And the screen is maximized, having one border at the top, one at the right and one at the bottom. In the event that we desire to enjoy the app in full screen, we hit this app icon. And we might already be experiencing and enjoying the video game in 100% screen mode. To get out of the complete screen setting, push the F11 key. And we might already play in normal display screen mode. At present, I am going to show you the keys mapping which is definitely very exciting. That strategy we will certainly be ready to operate the game app more easily. The first task is to click on this application icon. It's now time to make the appropriate adjustments. I most certainly will leave the standard settings, however if you prefer to improve that, you can easily do it without any problem. Clearly, the emulator is completely in our language. In certain cases it happens that your emulator is launched in the incorrect language, such as, in Japanese. And therefore to set it in the right language we go there to the cogwheel. Then here within various other configurations, we click the language drop down. We can pick the language we need, Italian, Chinese, and so forth. After the language is decided, we would save, the emulator would reboot, as well as the game, next time we launch it, would also be in the specified language. At this point, there is another detail that we need to take into account, and this is that we will receive an email telling you that a brand new machine has been connected with our own Google account. It will certainly ask us if we are the individuals who have associated with that device. Absolutely, we should not worry, because the emulator is behaving like an Google Android smartphone or tablet. In order to see which device is currently being emulated, we arrive right here, to the cogwheel and we just click on it. And so we go here to the model option. And there we discover that the emulator is simulating a Samsung cell phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all folks, so much for the video tutorial. I believe you appreciated it, especially that you thought it was handy. If that's the case, bring it a superb thumb up, subscribe to the channel, and any feedback, requests or suggestions, let them in the comment box below. You can also comment things on my Twitch channel, I actually do live streams occasionally, you have it below in the video description and in the initial pinned comment. Mouse click on any of the instructional videos that are showing up on the computer screen and see you in the future video tutorials. Bye.